What's going on, guys? My name's Jaren, but people on the internet call me Jaramon, and the NBA draft lottery is right around the corner. But have you ever stopped to ask yourself, what exactly is the draft lottery and how does it work? Well, if you have, today's your lucky day because we're going to be breaking down the process itself to help you better understand how exactly the draft lottery works and where your favorite team may or may not be picking in the upcoming NBA draft. By definition, the draft lottery is an annual event in which teams who had missed the playoffs during the previous season participate in a lottery process to determine the order in which each of the 14 non-playoff teams will be selecting in the forthcoming NBA draft. Now, currently, the draft lottery only determines the top three picks, but each of the 14 teams who did not make the playoffs do have a shot at selecting first overall, but their odds of receiving that first overall pick increase or decrease based on their win-loss record during the regular season. For example, the team with the least amount of regular season wins has a 25% chance at securing the number one pick, while the team with the most amount of wins who did not make the playoffs only has a 0.5% chance. Yeah, you heard that correctly. A 0.5% chance. Now, after the first three picks are determined, the remaining 11 picks, 4 through 14, are ranked based on each team's win-loss record, with the remaining team with the least amount of wins picking fourth, and so on and so forth. Okay, so there's the math behind the NBA draft lottery, but how does the league actually pick each team's draft position? Well, that's where the ping pong balls come to play. 14 ping pong balls numbered 1 through 14 are placed in a lottery machine, while a league representative randomly selects 4 balls revealing a 4-number combination, which lines up with one of the 14 lottery team's selection of combinations. Now, each lottery team has a certain number of 4-number combinations, with the top lottery team having 250 combinations, while the bottom lottery team only receives 5. But remember, this is a lottery, so there are no guarantees, and that can lead to some pretty crazy surprises, such as the 08 Chicago Bulls, who only had a 1.7% chance at getting the number one pick, which they eventually used to draft Derrick Rose. Or how about the 2014 Cleveland Cavaliers, who had the same exact odds, but even more shockingly, when they secured that number one pick in 2014, that became their third number one overall pick in the span of 4 years. What are the odds? Now remember, these are just the current rules. Next year in 2019, things are gonna be a little different. The league recently announced that they would be updating the odds in the draft lottery to bring more parity to the league and help make things feel a little more competitive. So no longer will the team with the least amount of wins solely hold the best odds at the number one spot, as the updated odds awards the bottom three teams with equal odds at 14% a pop. But again, these updated odds won't be in effect until 2019, so you won't have to worry about them until next year. Now, teams do have a right to use their picks in trades, and once a team trades their pick to another team, that pick will be determined by the original team's record, not by the record of the team who receives the pick. And that's why you see teams like the Boston Celtics ending up with the first overall pick in the 2017 NBA draft while still being the first seed in the Eastern Conference, as well as teams like my Los Angeles Lakers, who traded away their pick, so they won't be having a lottery selection in this year's draft. Today, guys, have it. That's everything you need to know about the NBA draft lottery. Be sure to head over to NBA.com with the link in the description box below for all the lottery updates and news. And also check out my channel, youtube.com/Jaramon, for more basketball and sneaker-related content just like this. My name is Jaren. It's been great having you. Catch you in the next one. Peace. That's one of the reasons why I was super excited to play in these. And this is a sneaker that actually has a couple of issues on paper, but despite those issues, I still really, really enjoyed playing in these, and I'll tell you why. But first, let's start, as always, with the thing that stood out to me the most, and that would be the fit.